Buddy, I'm back for another live stream. I was away for a couple weeks, but I'm back today. Gonna be working on some character stickers of my Wolfski Genji here, and I'm hoping to use these from upcoming video reviews, which I really should get back to. And it's been a long time coming, working on new character slides, and I've always needed the practice with facial expressions, so this is my first batch, and we'll see how this one goes. And then I'll, after, if this goes well, then I'll continue on with a few more sets or so. But this is, first run. Sketched on a larger sketch pad, and I got my basic line art and basic colors. Now I'm gonna continue onward with details, facial, eyes and eyebrows, mouths, and shading, and we'll see how far we get tonight. All right, let's see. Gotta do ears and eyebrows and mouths and eyes first. Then I'll get into jacket details, the zipper and the hood and the pockets. Originally, my first set of character slides were of human version of Genji, but I decided to go with a the Wolfski version for those slides now, just because he's, I guess I'm more my online slides, I've been associated more of the Wolfski character, which makes sense. I draw him a lot more than the human variant, and the human version I still need to use for other things. Haven't quite gone to those other things yet, but he's there, and much more different. This one's more of a, this character's more of a, projection of myself. And the other one is too, to a lesser extent. Just, that's a long story, but, yeah. Hang on. Everyone's been having a good weekend so far. Mine's been pretty good. I posted a picture on my Instagram of the lunch I had, which was a fantastic turkey mushroom burger from this place called Willie's Grill. They have really good food there. They have a nice kind of, I don't know, maybe folksy would be a proper term. Like a place I'm not typically wouldn't go to, but this one I been to once before, and I went to it again today, and the food's good. Really good seasoned fries, good burgers and milkshakes. Besides, you kind of want that kind of, how should I describe this? Probably getting the right layer for that. Again, trying to get to drawing the eyebrows on the sixth layer instead of the first layer, so I have less to worry about on that, full line art layer. be quite tricky to get the eyebrows to look right on all the faces. Eyebrows are weakest of mine. I just kind of made this character have big ones and stuck with that since I started drawing him. It's also kind of a facial feature that connects him and his dad. They both have, you know, thick eyebrows. I got a really lovely commission from a good friend of mine, Easy D Bud, of my this character, my Wolski, and his wolf dad, and I posted on it's on my Twitter at Gaming Genji. I have retweeted his post of it, and it's just a fantastic picture. Let me see if I can pop it open here. Hang on. Here we go. So he drew that for me, you know, my Wolski and his dad. I just really love these, like, father-son moment images. And he's drawn both characters before separately, so I just wanted to see them together in his style. And I mean, I love this picture. I think he did a fantastic job, and it's just so sweet. So, I mean, check him out, Easy D Bud, on Twitter. He does amazing work, and he I don't know if he has any slots open now, because they just opened 3 and they were filled up. I was one of the 3. Yeah, give him a watch. I highly recommend his work. Super, super nice guy. Alright. Get back and do the eye. I just want to make sure I kind of get these first few steps done on all of them. At least I can look at these kind of separate steps and kind of get them to match throughout the 6 images. So I don't have to redo so much if I say, oh wow, this one looks really off from the others and such. Pretty much going to be the case for the eyebrows. Because when I was working on this earlier, doing the initial line art, I had to redo bits of the collars on the hoodie on a few of them to make them match. And when he's on a sketch earlier, I kind of had all the tails going up. I thought for some emotions, maybe having the tails lowered fit better. So we'll see how that works. It's kind of like more like the happy and excited faces, like the tail should be up, while the more kind of like irritated or unimpressed faces would be have the tail down, like, really? So, yeah. Despite how many times I draw this character, I just don't think about his tail as much as I should. The tail is also another kind of feature that he shares with his dad. Like, he has the half white, half black design that his mom's tail has, but it's as long as his dad's tail. The mom has a shorter tail. I need to make that a bit more consistent too. That's the case, because I really want to make it that it's believable that the wolf dad is like the dad of this wolf, the Wolfski character. You know, my Wolfski has more the fur pattern of his husky mom, and so do the twins, like his older brother characters that are look a bit more like the dad, mostly because they have gray fur like him, while Genji here has white fur, like the mom. So, yeah. see if I can fit in a live stream next weekend. I'm not sure because that's, Mother's Day weekend. And also the weekend Detective Pikachu comes out, which I've got to get a watch, which I got to see. Maybe I'll see it that weekend or the next weekend. Yeah, because I want to review that. Because I haven't done a movie review in months. I'm gonna see if I can also get some music reviews too. Just kind of review what I've been listening to or what's been interesting me. Maybe some classic album reviews. We'll see what happens. Should also probably see if I can review those. I still need to do a review of season 7 of Venture Brothers, even though that's been many months. Well, just ended last saw early fall or so, but yeah, just kind of thinking about also doing a video sometime of ranking the like the 7 seasons so far of the Venture Brothers from worst to best. Because I was actually thinking about that pretty hard, because that's a show that's gone through such a lengthy evolution. Because it's a show where like you watch like the first season, it's like radically different from like the first two seasons, like and then every and it's just like it just shifts so much, like from like the third from like the second season to the third season, and so on. And the first season is pretty rough in hindsight. Like it's not bad, but it's really rough around the edges, and particularly the animation style. And that was also like when they kind of really had it more so as just a Johnny Quest pastiche. But a after like a, like maybe like halfway through season 1, definitely getting into season 2, like when like the it shifts and becomes its own show. Sure, I'll wallow about how long those eyes go. Again, part of it has to do with the eyebrows, which I'm gonna have to fix. That. I have some friends who've done these character sketches, or character stickers, I should say. And they look. I'm always impressed by them just because, I mean, I always feel bad for my own. Bad about my facial expressions. I need to work on kind of more varied ones. Better late than never, so. yeah, another easy debut. He also offers you can purchase sticker commissions from him, and they're amazing. I mean, I haven't purchased any, but I've seen his work for those, and those are really, really nice. Ooh. How's that eyebrows a little short? Let's see if I can lengthen that a smidge. Eyes give me so much stress. So far, the early reviews of the Pokemon Detective Pikachu movie look favorable so far. Mostly, I've heard them saying it's like the best video game movie so far, which is. Well, let's be honest, that's a low bar. I mean, video game movies, you know, the good ones are like the first Resident Evil movie and maybe the first Silent Hill movie, but everything else is just hot garbage most of the time, so. But yeah, I'm really looking forward to seeing it. And I'm kind of warming up to the style. At first I was like really turned off by some of the design look, but I guess that's kind of, you know, a bit rough looking from the trailer or just. I don't know, I'm a bit more optimistic for the Detective Pikachu movie. So, guess we'll find out in a week or two. Well, I mean, more people will find out in a week. I'll find out probably in a week or, you know, if I can't match that, next weekend. Or the weekend after that. Yikes. Oh, when you do mouths. Whoopsies. Mouths are also a part where, place where I get particularly picky with how they look. Well, I need to figure out something to draw for Mother's Day. I'm not sold on that. I'm gonna see if I can get some sketching done tomorrow and, you know, get something to work with for that. I'd like to draw something again. Like last year, I drew my Wolfsky character as a, you know, small, like pup hugging his mom. And I want to draw the mom again, but one of the ideas I had was to have her with her other two sons when they were younger. So I'm going to try for that. And then there's also a sketch of her that I finished the sketch, I just haven't colored it yet, so that's on my to-do list as well. So if I can't think of anything, I'll just probably finish that. I should finish it anyway at some point, so yeah. One of the problems of becoming a character like fur like this kind of blends the background, so yeah. Right. Hairline's a bit off on this one. A little high. Let me see if I can lower that a tiny bit. Ooh. I think that looks a little bit better. Oh, I'm gonna need a lower on this one. Yeah. I forgot what the expression is for what it's called when you... I'm not great at keeping my characters on model. So having this, like, you know, it's one thing, like, well, for one, I don't draw comics too often, so don't get too much practice from that. But for something like this, it's giving me kind of a lot of, you know, quite a bit of practice trying to get my characters to look on model together. I don't know. Maybe when I could just, you know, be great to have more practice of that overall, so... And if these stickers go over well, it's possible I might someday offer them as commissions. So, we'll see. I mean, technically, I'm still open for commissions. I never closed them, but just. Not a lot of interest right now, but you know, if you're interested, just hit me up and we'll see what we can make happen. There's also quite a lot of art I want to do for myself as well. And technically, this is something I want to be doing for myself as too, for my video content, my own practice. Gosh, there's so many video scripts I need to finish. Even more I need to start, but that's neither here nor there. I mean, it's kind of here. It's also a little bit there, but not right now. So I need to see what I can do about getting a better reference for my character's hair too, because a lot of times it doesn't really bother me, but sometimes artists will draw his hair in a way that's off to me. Like, so his hair only spikes in the front, like there's like the bangs, you know, spiked up. But some artists kind of interpret it differently, and yeah, part of that comes from me not drawing him from too many, you know, angles, which is another thing I need to improve on. Yeah, but hair, I'm also just generally need a lot more practice of hair. All right. Well, this hairline looks a bit too high too. Drawing the face palm expression was particularly fun. Oh, I enjoy a good face palm moment. Also trying to figure out what to do for like an angry expression for my sticker pack. Cause like the arms crossed and sour face would be kind of like the go-to for that expression for now, like next video or so before I get to the next set of stickers. So, but like for like a more kind of genuinely like angry expression, I'm trying to see what I can do that would work. Okay, those are a bit more consistent. I'm a tiny bit worried I made the hairline's a little too low. Head looks weird on this one. Let me see. Alright, looks like I tend to have a mix. Again, you know, not great at keeping my character on model from picture to picture, frame to frame. At least this face is gonna be a bit easier since, well, his hands are covered. His eyes are mostly covered. I do need to do fingernails. do jack details afterwards. Alright. Yeah, these eyebrows are messed up. Just gotta get rid of this. The brown of the eyebrows is kind of throwing me off with my line art. Ooh, that's the wrong layer. while I'm here, let me add in the blush. Use my Wolfsky standard blush here. Oh, I forgot his mouth on that one. Okay. Oh, someone buzzed me. Alright. Ugh. Ooh, hands are a weakness of mine. Ooh, I got the. Yeah, the pen I was using was too thick for those. Okay. Those hands. How am I gonna do this? Alright. No, that's not good. Oh gosh, I hate these fingernails. And these fingers, kind of, but ugh. Okay, let's see here. Oh, I'm feeling beat. Ugh. Alright. Gotta try to do the eyes then. See how I feel. But. Ugh, feeling sleepy. Oh, excuse me, had to sneeze. Hang on. I feel like I should make those pupils bigger. Yeah. Oh, excuse me. Might be too big though. I don't know if I can get all the eyes done today. Call it a night for tonight. I still keep working on these, of course, but I'm just, I don't know. Just kind of really feeling a bit, sleepy. And I still need to do some other things before that, but, yeah, I think I'll call it a stream for today. I want to thank everyone for watching live or, on YouTube, so you can catch this recording my Twitch channel, Gaming Genji on Twitch, or YouTube, Gaming Genji on YouTube, and at Gaming Genji on Twitter for updates on streams, videos, and pictures, drawings, and such, and, you know, super, and also most of my pictures are on DeviantArt, well, a lot of my pictures are on DeviantArt, Super Genji on DeviantArt, and, yeah. Thank you so much for watching. I'll catch you all next time.